Say, neighbor, today is my day, and my God will remember me. In the mighty name of Jesus. If you know you believe today is your day, shout a louder hallelujah. Shout a resounding hallelujah. Amen. With your joy, just keep standing with your joy. Jam your hands together for Jesus. Celebrate. My father, my mentor, my mobile temple, my spiritual feather. Jam is celebrate, not any other person. Senior pastor God in Ube. Oh my God, is how you will celebrate grace. Oh, Shakarabo Zila Meza. Is how you celebrate grace. If only you celebrate grace, that great that work for you will disgrace your enemies. I say, celebrate your father, celebrate your mentor, celebrate your mobile temple, celebrate your spiritual feather, celebrate him, celebrate him, celebrate him. Oh my God, is it working? It will come to reality in the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, I get to understand by scripture, but the virtue of creation, man have reduced. Because the Bible makes us understand in the book of Genesis, he said when God created Adam, he led Adam to be asleep. And by the lips of Adam, he created Eve. Praise God. That is to show by the virtue of creation, man have reduced. And for man to have a glorious destiny fulfilled, he needs a woman that will stand by him. Can you just hear me? The kind of woman you marry determines how far you will go. Oh my God. Oh, the kind of woman you engage yourself with determines how far you will go. I saw the jealousy in the house. Can you just join her together and celebrate? My mother, my spiritual mother, mama, I celebrate you. Are you just looking like that? Oh, Shakarabu Ziladeja. Your enemies are in trouble. In the mighty name of Jesus. Don't worry. After today's meeting, the angel of God will empower your wife. And you become great. Look at the way our daddy is smiling. Oh, daddy, God bless you. Look at the way he's smiling. You look at my man, just put a smile. Can't just celebrate daddy in the house. Celebrate him. Celebrate Junior Jacob. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Sons and daughter of earth from above here at the Ram Ministry. You are wonderfully made. Celebrate yourself. Celebrate yourself. Because today, God is about to do something great in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Quickly sit down and never go down and begin to bless your enemies. Make sure you sit at the head of your enemies. Call the name of that stubborn mother-in-law, that stubborn father-in-law, that stubborn uncle, that stubborn siblings of yours. Said, I sit on your head today. In the mighty name of Jesus, they have been speaking against you, but today, the word of God will prevail in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved ladies and gentlemen, when I was asked to speak today, I said, God, what do you have for your children? And the Lord make me to understand that his word will prevail in the life of his children. Praise God. There are three words in the life of every human. The word of God concerning you, and the kind of word you speak concerning yourself, and what people say concerning you. Beloved, what people say concerning you have no relevance to your destiny. But the word of God is supreme. The word of God is supernatural. The word of God is the key to your success. And I pray for you today, that word of God will prevail over your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I come to my to say, oh God, let your word prevail. The reason why you see some people are gambling, things are not working up to expectation, is because they are walking outside the word of God in their life. But today, I am glad to announce to somebody under the sound of my voice that the word of God will prevail over your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, the word of God will make manifest in your life. Indeed, by the word of God is the spiritual tools for divine destiny fulfillment. The word of God is the spiritual tools for divine destiny fulfillment. Two, the word of God is a process of reminding him of his promises. The word of God is a channel of reminding God of his promises. Quickly, let's see in the scripture in Jeremiah 29. Verse 11. If you are there, you can read because of time. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. The word of God is a process of reminding him of his promises. If you are there, you can read. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. Praise God.
And I will make Jerusalem.
No. I know the thought that I have towards you, says the Lord. Not of peace, not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. A thought of good, not of evil, to give you a future. Another scripture says to give you an expected end. And I prophesy to your life today, every good thing the Lord has said concerning today will come to reality. In the mighty name of Jesus, every good glory that heaven has destined for you. Children, I pray for my husband. I have prayed for my business. I have prayed for my marriage. But it's not yet coming. I hear to prophesy. Every word of the enemy that is speaking against your life, speaking against your destiny, speaking against your glory, from your father's house, from your mother's house, in your place of birth, in your village, in your community, today I command it to come and end. Our end is coming now. The word of God will prevail. The word of God will prevail. The word of God will prevail. In the name of Jesus. Number three. If you can come in, if you can connect to God's word, he's willing to be committed for action. If you can connect yourself to God's words, God is ever ready for his action. Our sister here shared a testimony that was having constant flow for good 50 years. She said she got to a point, she began to dig in the Bible and found where it was written concerning the woman of the issue of blood. And she hooked on the word and began to remind God, Father, this is what you said, and this is what come to pass. Why my whole life is different? She came to that word, and she came to this service here. Our Father, the Lord, here declared a word and came to it, and her story changed. Beloved, it's a dear to me. I'm here to announce to you today, every evil word of the enemy concerning you is hereby canceled. Is hereby canceled. Is hereby canceled. Is hereby canceled. In the mighty name of Jesus. There is the book of Mark 5 verse 25 to 29. The woman of the issue of blood. She said she came to the world. Say, God, you do this thing for a woman. Why my own case is different? If you can connect yourself to God's word, God is fully committed to bring your dream to reality. Praise God. Number four. Any Christian, anybody that calls himself a Christian that does not know his or her own right in Christ, the enemy took advantage of him. That is the reason why you see some false prophets. They say because we belong to a social place, that is why something good is coming, is not coming out of your life. Why? You don't know your right in Christian. The Bible says, I know the plan that I have for you is of good, not of evil, but to give you an expected end. Number five, the word of God is a spiritual bullet to terminate spiritual affliction. The word of God is a spiritual bullet to terminate spiritual affliction. In the same way we use normal drugs to terminate physical affliction. When you are feeling headache or whatever, leg pain or stomach pain, whatever and all that, you go to the hospital. But doctor by then will recommend a drug for you. Say, take this and take that, everything will be over. And the same way, no matter the situation you find yourself in life, you need the word of God to conquer it. No matter the condition you find yourself, there is a word that is attached to it. But I'm here to announce to somebody, the word of God will prevail in your life today. The word of God will bring to pass every good thing that heaven has said concerning you. In the mighty name of Jesus. How do I know? Number one, in Deuteronomy 8:18. Deuteronomy 8:18. If you are there, you carry. He said, I'm the Lord, the God who gives you the power to get wealth. I am the Lord, the God who gives you the power to prosper. But why are you still living in abject poverty? Why not pick up your Bible and lament God? God, this is what you say concerning my life. This is what you say concerning my destiny. You say you give her power to get wealth. Now I am available to get that wealth. I'm here to announce to you, after today you will prosper. In your business you will prosper. In your business you will prosper. In your marriage you will prosper. In your endeavor you will prosper. In the mighty name of Jesus. How do I know number two? In Genesis 1:28, if you are there, you can read. The Bible said, the Lord said, he blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth. Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth. That is to show barrenness have no part in your life. Unfruitfulness have no part in your life. Frustration and disappointment have no part in your life. Today, as the Lord liveth that the Spirit of God is alive, by the covenant that established this commission, by the grace that work in the life of our Father, the Lord, Senior Pastor God Ube, by heavenly supernatural backing, anyone that said you will not carry your children, I command them to die. Oh my God. Anyone that said you will never get married, I command them to die. Anyone that said you will not prosper, I command them to die. In the mighty name of Jesus, I command them to die. 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 Who is saying no to your life? Who is saying no to your destiny? Who for you will not prosper? Who for you will not carry your children? Who for you will never drive a good car? Who for you will not build a house? Who for you will not make it that family? Who for you will not get married? Ladies and gentlemen, I sit on this altar. Wherever they are, I command them to die. I command them to die. I command them to die. I see the head of that witch. I command it to die. I see the head of that woman. I command it to die. Who for that will not succeed? Who for that will not be promoted? Who for that will not make it? Who is that woman? Who is that man? That value will not succeed. Ladies and gentlemen, I stand under the grace of God that established this commission. I had under the spiritual prophetic mystery of my Father, the Lord, Senior Pastor God Ube, by heavenly social back, I command your enemy to die. I command your enemy to die. I command your enemy to die. Any strong woman, any strong man that sit in one place, that value will not make it. I sit on this altar. I command her to die. 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 somebody is coming out. You are coming out from that curse. You are coming out from frustration. You are coming out from barrenness. You are coming out from barrenness. You are coming out from downfall. You are coming out from poverty. You are coming out from delay marriage. Lakataba, let shakaba, let shakaba, let shakaba, let shakaba, let shakaba. I decree upon your life. I prophesy from today. You will make it. You will make it. It will be a sharp fire. 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 Ladies and gentlemen, you don't serve a dead God. Of the living God. It is the same yesterday and today and forever. When you say yes, no one can say no. When you lift you up, no one can bring you down. When you open your door, no one can close it. When you give you a key, no one can collect it. When you give you children, no one can collect it. Marriage coming your way, glory coming your way, favor coming your way, prosperity coming your way, joy coming your way. Take that promotion. Oh my God. Oh my God. Something is happening on that. Oh my God. 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 Shataba. Praise God. There's a divine visitation for a woman here. You are a woman. You are married before you have children. But God said He wants to repackage you. That repackage, that divine marital settlement. The reason is that what will survive you in your old age. A woman, you are here. You are married before, you had children, but now you are no more in marriage again. I don't want to call you out, but God said He wants to repackage you. He said He wants to repackage you. The angels of God in this commission, John Asher, they are very much active now. Make sure you get yourself connected, because fire is open right now. A profile is being opened. I am seeing a channel of children. There is a catalog of blessing this altar. Le kobashira, la kutu parandoji malazemira abazera doja, la kwanguanguan lange doji masi paratoshi kabaraswa. Le kete paleso. The angels of this commission, they are in this altar with a different gift, with a different package, with a different gift, with a different package. If you can connect. Oh my God, look at what God is doing. Look at what God is doing. Look at what God is doing. Look at that, brother. Look at what God is doing. Look at. God is restoring you. A new crown is coming to your head. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Yes, yes. A new crown is coming. A new crown is coming. Look at that, brother. Help that, brother. Help that, brother. Help that, brother. A new crown is coming. Yeah. A new crown is coming. I see a dew, a rain of blessing. A rain of blessing. Beloved, just get ready. I saw you brought to this commission. Enemy will not see your downfall. As far you belong to this commission, your enemy will not laugh at you. Ah, shata. Oh my God. This woman, I speak again. When this thing happened, don't resist it. That thing is packaged for heaven to secure you in your old age. In your old age. God said He got to repackage you. The God of this commission said, I'm going to repackage you. He said, I will take away that old garment. I will take away that shame. I will take away that reproach. I will take away that disaster. I will take away frustration. I will take away that mocking of men. I'm about to make you. I am about to make you. He said, men have been mocking you. Your former healer have been mocking you. People around will be mocking you. He said, but from today, the God that works not because of God will be. He will make you. 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 It will bless your fire. Shall fire, shall fire, shall fire, shall fire, shall fire, eh, Shababa, shall fire, he's coming again, shall fire, he's coming, shall fire, shall fire, shall fire, shall fire, ah, just an arrow, that arrow is for good. He pointed straight to choir stand. The angels of this commission, they're on assignment to make a billionaire. Can you hear me now? I am not a tazzy with a word, but I'm telling the mind of God concerning you. The angels of God in this commission, they're on assignment to ordain a billionaire. The angels that work with senior pastor God Ube, the restoration of the generation is an assignment to make a billionaire, to make a billionaire, to make a billionaire. A project is signed already with set of white men. Ah, Shakarabusa. There is a project is signed with a set of white men. Help that brother, help that brother. A project is signing. A project is signing. Somebody that will owe you money, but after this message, that money will be paid. Ah, Shakata Balindo Jimalapo Saba. I heard God say 24 hours. I heard he say 24 hours. I heard he say 24 hours. I heard he say 24 hours. Sir, I speak to your life. People are laughing at you. Basi, don't worry. God said, I know your work. Those you help, they look down. But God said, I know your work. I saw a wings, an arrow that entered this choir sign. He said, I want to make a billionaire. He said, I want to make a billionaire. I prophesy by the mandate of God upon my life. I stand under the covenant that established this commission. Help from above, Ilya and different ministry. I had myself under the grace of my father, the mobile temple, the spiritual destiny restorer of this generation, senior pastor God Whoopi, by heavenly supernatural backing. Take the mandate now. 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 In the name of Jesus. Somebody, you are here, you see yourself a coffee at the hours of the night. You see yourself a coffee. You see yourself a coffee in the night. But when you wake up from that dream, you forgot. You could not address that dream with prayer. But you saw yourself in a coffee in the dream of the night. You saw yourself a coffee in the dream of the night where people gather you. But to wake up from that dream, the dream you forgot, I do not address that dream. But as I speak right now, the angels of God in this commission, they are bringing you out from that coffee. They are bringing you out from that coffee. They are bringing you out from that coffee. I say you are coming out. 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 I said that coffee of fire.
him on fire. I set him on fire. Hear this. Whatever that coffee I made to bury in your life, today I scatter him. Ah, shakarabu same jojima tuzi warabu likotoshi kabaza. Le kwa kwa likoto para semi kotoshi kabaza. Le kende bilaso simadoja. Whatever that coffee I made to bury your life, I bring you out from that coffee. 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 He come again. He said, I want to make a billionaire in this commission. Praise God. Billionaire, Tanzania, millionaires, they have only one head. The same way you do a transaction and make a million, in the same format, you make a billion. But right now, as I speak from this altar, the angel of God that will channel you to that direction, the angel of God that will lead destiny helper to you, that will usher you where people begin to help you, that will usher you when your mocker will come and begin to see the making of God in your life, that will usher you to that seat of honor, to that seat of celebration, to that seat of glory. Receive that angel now. Receive it 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 now. Let's see it down. Let's see it down. Let's see it down. Let's see it down. What are the word of God? The word of God bring forth divine health. Sit at the head of your enemies. From today, you are in charge. You are in control. Praise God. Sit on their head. You can do anything on their head to pollute them. They will rise no more. In the name of Jesus. The word of God. For you, it brings what? Divine health. Quickly, you are with your Bible. Let's see in the book of Exodus 23, verse 26. Quickly, because of time. Quickly, it brings forth divine health. Glory be to God. Shakapola soma dojizia. La kwana. Exodus 23, verse 26. Exodus number 23.
They shall not have their young, nor be barren in thy land.
They shall not cast their young,
nor be barren in the land.
Or be barren in the land.
The number of thy days.
The number of thy days.
I will fulfill.
Shall ye be fulfilled.
Amen.
They shall not cast their young. Who vowed that you will use your hand to bury your children? They shall not cast the young, the word of God concerning you. Who vowed that will have a miscarriage? They shall not cast the young. Who vowed that you will use your eye to see the grave of your child? They shall not cast the young. Who vowed that you buy casket for your child? I decree on this altar, every evil word concerning your fruitfulness, concerning your family, concerning your children, I command it to backfire. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus, I prophesy to your life. I prophesy to your family. I prophesy the life of your children. Anyone that vow, because they cannot kill you, because they cannot stop you, you are enjoying the grace of Pastor God Ubi. But remember, your children is elsewhere. They can live anyhow life. They want to take advantage of them. They can live anyhow life. They want to take a chance for their living. I decree on this altar, any man or woman that will point an accusing finger against your children, I command them to die. I command them to die. You will not bury your children. 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 In the name of Jesus. He said, there shall not be barren in the land. Speak a word. a war. I prophesy today, any dead womb by the angels of God that walk on this commission, I bring you back to life. I bring you back to life. In the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for somebody right here. Any man or woman, they have put a bishop or a bishop the names in a pot and strut and pour blood inside the pot. And the person said, as I am drinking the blood inside the pot, I am dry up the destiny of this person. Wherever, where that pot is planted, and whosoever they have planted the pot, and any evil authority supervising that pot in any altar, in any shrine, the thunder of God is about to strike them now. Wherever that pot is planted, a bishop, a name in the pot, and they strut out blood inside the pot, the person will stand up and drink the blood. He said, as I'm drinking this blood, I am dry up the well-being of this fellow. As I'm drinking this blood, I am reducing this sister gradually. I am reducing the brother gradually. Any infirmity in your body right now, God is about to do something. Everybody be on standing. God is about to do something. The wind is about to blow right now. Any infirmity in your body, whatever the enemies have planted in your body, right now it's going out. Now, right now it's leaving you. It's returning back to center. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, my Father, every evil war concerning my life, concerning my destiny, backfire. Come on, there, come on, there. Evil war concerning my business, concerning my finances, concerning my ministry, concerning my children, concerning my womb, concerning my marriage, concerning my children, concerning my wife, wherever you are. Joshua, that evil word have arrested and captured you. Shakalobusa. Shakabusa. Say, oh Lord, my Father, any part of my life under satanic prison by evil word, right now, I jump out from it now. Jump out now. Jump out now. Jump out now. Jump under, 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 in Jesus' mighty name. Hear this. In Joshua 1 verse 3, the Bible says, wherever the sole of your feet shall tread upon, that you will possess your possession. In verse 5, he said, no any man can be able to stand before you all the days of your life. He said, as the Lord be with Moses, he said, I will be with you from today. He said, I will not fail you, neither will I forsake you. Ladies and gentlemen, I prophesy to your life. After today, because you are dropped off of that satanic poster, wherever your feet shall tread upon, you will possess your possession. That feet, it will take you to your bed. If you are here, you are believing God for fruit of the womb. He said, wherever the soul of your feet shall tread upon, that you will possess your possession. So if the soul of your feet take you to your bed, you when you are there with your husband, you will possess your possession. You will possess your possession. From today, I decree upon your life, anywhere you will enter, wherever you will enter with your two legs, you will possess your possession. You will possess your possession. You will possess your possession. In that court case, you will possess your possession. In that court case, you will possess your possession. In that business, you will possess your possession. In the mighty name of Jesus, I prophesy from today, anyone that will rise up against you, I command the air to open up and swallow them. Any man or woman that will rise up against you, because the Bible says, he will not fail you. God will not disappoint you. He said, as he be with Moses, he will be with you. From today, anyone that vowed to stop you, heaven will stop them. Heaven will stop them. It will be a shout fire. Shout fire. Shout fire. Say, neighbor, I am blessed. I am blessed. And so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name. Quickly, join together for Jesus. Keep clapping to the glory of God and to the shame of your enemies. In Jesus' mighty name. Quickly, if you have your tithe, step out with your tithe. So the word of God will prevail in your life. So his mercy will prevail in your business. Because the only way you can have contact with his word or to when you obey instruction. Because it is instruction that delivers a man from destruction. When you hearken unto the instruction of God, he delivers you from destruction of men. Are you hearing me now? What did I say? When you hearken unto the instruction of God by paying your tithe in full. Praise God. Not just let me pay. No, pay your tithe in full, 10% of your income. Try it and see what God will do in your life. When you follow God's instruction, he delivers you from men's destruction. Right now, lift up that tithe above your hands and begin to prophesy to that tithe. Say, Father, I'm here with my tithe in my hand. I obey your instruction. Deliver me from every financial destruction. Yes. Pray that prayer. Pray it right now. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. As you pay your tithe today, every good door the enemies have locked up against you, I see them open right now on their own accord. In the mighty name of Jesus, quickly drop your tithe and package a quality offering to wipe away your suffering. An offering that will terminate your generational suffering. An offering, oh my God. Package a quality offering. Package a quality offering that will wipe away your suffering. Lift up your offering before the Lord. I begin to speak to it right now. Say, oh God, I come here with my offering. Let this offering wipe away my suffering. Let this offering terminate every journey of suffering in my life. And so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Hail my Jesus. Somebody hail my Jesus. I say hail my Jesus. Can you be on your feet and give the Lord a dance of victory? Hail my Jesus. Been around the world. miracle. I found no one. Let me hear you say, nobody like you. Been so many places, searching for a better life, searching for a better. I found no one. Give the Lord a dance. Ijo, 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 Ijo. Come and see, oh, come and see. Come and see what the Lord has done. Come and see what the Lord. Come and see. Come and see what the Lord has done. Come and see what the Lord has done. Come and see, oh, come and see. Give the Lord a dance of victory. Are you still looking at that?
Remember, on Tuesday by 8 a.m., we have one of our sisters from Atlanta, Georgia. She'll be coming to talk to us for 30 minutes on that day. She's already in the country. She'll be in Abuja tomorrow by 8 a.m., first flight. Praise the Lord. So Tuesday, please come early so you can hear and when he's going to speak Queen English for us. I know the demon will understand the English. Praise the Lord. He's going to talk to us about dominion, prosperity. Praise the Lord. So please come early on that day. Let's rise on our feet now. Let's appreciate the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Wave your hand for the blessing of today. Because the blessing of God maketh rich, yet no sorrow. That everything you collected from the Almighty God today, sorrow will not be attached to it. Wave your hand. Bless the name of the Lord. Appreciate him. Say thank you, Jesus, for making me to be alive. Talk to the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Keep us standing as we are going to sing our closing hymns. One, two, and the last. God bless you, sir.
Consecrated Lord, to thee take my moments and my days. Let them flow in ceaseless praise. We take verse 1, verse 2, and last verse 6.
Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my moments and my days. Let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my hands and let them move at the impulse of thy love. Take my feet and let them be sweet and beautiful for thee. Take my Lord, I pour at thy feet his treasure store. Take myself and I will be ever only all for thee.
Amen. Let's share the grace in fellowship. Surely, before you shout hallelujah, those that are expecting great thing that is being delayed, immediately they shout the hallelujah, come and kneel down in the altar, outside the microphone, I want to pray for you. One powerful hallelujah, let's go.
Please, men of purpose, let's meet the children right now, please. Don't go.